Meet my new console, the PowKitty RGB20S. This console served as the main prototype for another popular console, the R35S, which completely copied it. Moreover, my favorite console, the R36S, was also born in part thanks to this legendary PowKitty RGB20S. In this video, we will unbox the PowKitty RGB20S, discuss its software, and test some games. But first, let's take a look at the technical specifications. The RGB20S console is powered by the RK3326 processor, which consists of 4 Cortex-A35 cores. Graphics performance is handled by the Mali-G31MP2 GPU. The console has 1GB of DDR3 LRAM and a 3.5-inch IPS display with a resolution of 640 by 480 pixels. For storage, the console has 2 microSD card slots, one for the firmware and game collection, and the other solely for game storage. Inside the casing, there is a 3500 mAh battery, which should last for more than 4 hours of gameplay. Out of the box, the RGB20S runs on a Linux-based operating system with the ArcOS shell. This is an important factor since the console's price is competitive and comparable to the R36S, which has recently seen an influx of copies and clones. These clones run on the Emulek firmware, which lacks the extensive functionality and large community support that ArcOS offers. This is why I would recommend choosing the PowKitty RGB20S over the R36S, as it is a reliable and well-established brand with good pricing. By the way, I bought this console on AliExpress with free and very fast shipping. It arrived the day after my purchase. If you want to get an even better deal, be sure to use a promo code when ordering to receive an additional discount. You can find the link to the console and more details in the description box. Now, let's unbox the console. The RGB20S arrived in this nicely branded PowKitty box. Inside, we find some fun stickers that can be applied to the front panel of the console to achieve this look. Next, there is a user manual entirely in Chinese, but we won't need it. In the side compartment, there is a standard white USB Type-A to USB Type-C charging cable. Now let's take the device out of the box and examine it in more detail. The front panel is protected by a soft protective material. I ordered the console in the bright and cheerful yellow color. The plastic has a slightly matte finish and feels pleasant to the touch. Visually, everything looks quite familiar, but slightly reversed since I have been using the R36S for a long time. However, this console is significantly smaller in size. Let's turn on the console and check the ArcOS firmware version. As you can see, it boots up quite quickly. Now I'll navigate to the main menu. Here we can see that the SD card has a rather old firmware version installed. I will update it later and show you the entire installation process. At the bottom of the front panel, there are matte black buttons. They have a rubber membrane and provide a good tactile feel. These buttons allow for comfortable and extended gameplay sessions. Moving on to the D-pad, it has a matte surface and is also pleasant to the touch. It presses easily and comfortably. Based on its feel, it is a standard rubber membrane D-pad, but diagonal inputs register not only when pressed in two directions simultaneously, but even with slight tilts in one direction. This makes it a very convenient and high-quality D-pad for a budget console. Now let's look at the analog sticks. At first glance, their placement directly under the screen might seem inconvenient, but in my opinion, it depends on what you're used to and the type of games you play. If you enjoy games like GTA Vice City or Half-Life 2, where you need to navigate a 3D space using analog sticks most of the time, then this layout is very comfortable. Unlike most other consoles, the sticks are not recessed into the body and offer a good range of motion. They also have a slightly rubberized texture that feels nice to the touch. The Start, Select and Function buttons are designed as a cute smiley face with eyes and a mouth, which is a distinctive feature of PowKitty. This gives the console a friendly look. The only downside is that these buttons rattle and make unnecessary noise. Additionally, on the default ArcOS firmware, the Function button is unfortunately not mapped to any system functions. This is yet another reason to update ArcOS to a newer version. On the back of the console, there are four shoulder triggers. They have a pleasant but rather loud click. They also rattle slightly, creating some extra noise. On the sides, there are power and reset buttons, along with volume control buttons. These are almost flush with the console body, but still press well. The bottom of the console has two USB Type-C ports, one for charging and the other for connecting peripherals, such as a Wi-Fi adapter. Between them is a headphone jack. Out of the box, my console came with two SD cards. The first slot holds a 16GB SD card with the ArcOS firmware, while the second slot contains a 128GB SD card with the game collection. The second SD card appears to be branded, so I will leave it as is for now, but I will replace the first SD card with a Samsung one. I will use it to install the new ArcOS firmware. Since I use a MacBook, I will be following the installation instructions on macOS. And before we continue, please like and subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. This helps me promote the channel. Also, you can click the bell icon so you don't miss any new videos. Thank you for your attention. Let's continue. First, I need to download the latest firmware from GitHub. This firmware is compatible with several consoles, including the RGB20S. I download the version labeled Original Screen. Next, I extract the downloaded file using the free application The Unarchiver. Once extracted, we get another firmware file in IMG format, which we will use to write to the new SD card. To do this, I will use another free application called Etcher. By the way, you can find a step-by-step installation guide with links to all applications and the firmware site on my Telegram channel via the link in the description box. Subscribe for more interesting content. Now let's insert the new SD card into the laptop. First, I need to format it. I use the standard disk utility application. If you don't see your SD card in the side menu, but only see partitions, enable the Show All Devices option. Then I select the SD card, click Erase, choose the XFAT format, and confirm the action. Once the SD card is formatted, I open Etcher app to create a bootable SD card with the firmware. In the application window, I select the extracted firmware file in IMG format, then choose the new SD card as the target and finally click Flash. A window appears prompting me to enter my user password. Now I just have to wait for the installation to complete. After the process is finished, I remove the SD card and insert it into the first slot of the console. The second slot still holds game collection SD card. Now I turn on the console and the firmware installation begins. After a while, the console automatically restarts and we see the standard ArcOS interface. Looking closely, the image appears slightly shifted downward. This means we need to replace a boot file in the boot partition. I take out the new SD card and insert it into my laptop. I also insert the default SD card into my laptop. In the boot partition of the default SD card, I find this boot file and copy it to the exact same location on the new SD card, replacing the existing file. I also delete another file from the new SD card. Now I eject the SD card and insert it back into the console. Now I turn on the console and the interface displays correctly. Now I need to connect the second SD card with games. To do this, I go to the Options section, then Advanced, and at the very bottom of the list, I switch game reading to the second SD card. By the way, in the same Options section, you can set the device type to R35S or R36S. I also installed my custom interface theme on the console, because I like its minimalist look better. If you'd like to install the same theme on your console and support my channel, you can buy it on my Gumroad page via the link in the description box. Now that the console is set up and the firmware is updated to the latest version, I suggest testing a few games. Let's start with some simple games that this console can handle without any issues. Darkwing Duck for the classic Nintendo, a great game that runs without any problems. I really like that. Classic Sega games also run perfectly on this console. Playing them feels very comfortable. Game Boy Advance games, smooth gameplay, everything works flawlessly. Next up is Nintendo 64. The result is amazing. By the way, this game is a lot of fun. Here we go! GTA Vice City Stories for PSP, a very demanding game for this type of device. With optimized graphics settings and out-of-frame skipping, we see a fairly low FPS. I'd recommend playing simpler PSP games like LocoRoco or Little Big Planet for a more comfortable gaming experience. I also tested games from the Portmaster section, such as Half-Life, Half-Life 2, GTA Vice City, and others. They all run quite stably. Thanks to Portmaster, a huge number of additional games become available. By the way, the console has built-in vibration feedback, which for example activates in Half-Life 2 when you hit an enemy with a crowbar. In my opinion, the RGB20S is an excellent and well-built console that serves as a great alternative to the R36S and could be your first handheld console. It's affordable, fully supports ArcOS, and comes with an SD card loaded with a large collection of games. A reminder, you can find the link to the RGB20S in the description box. As for my impressions, I'm really glad that over time the price of this console has become more competitive, allowing more users to appreciate one of the best budget handhelds from the reliable and well-known brand PowKitty. I really like this console, and by the way, you get used to this control layout very quickly. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe to the channel. I wish you pleasant nostalgia and successful completion of your favorite games.